use along the bottom or the top lane. In this case, it would be along the top lane, and then go out. Chrono immediately blew up by a Kaka boat. They would find a kill every time. It was just like over and over and over again in the mid game. They were hiding in the trees constantly, and as soon as they would spot somebody move up to the creep wave, KP was incredibly patient. He would find himself kill. Oh my goodness gracious, what have I even done? This is not WESG at all. This is the Summit 6. Sorry about that, guys. And so because of that, I want to see if that dynamic still works. Oh no, there's no way, right? Does he spot that out? That would have been a third. He could have found a courier snipe that early on. Regardless, it's going to be a very interesting game. I can't wait to see how it goes. So far, we have zero loss as well, which is just icing on the cake of happiness, for me at least. And Ahmet, on his jug, is going to have to contend with the KP Sand King offlane. Blocks off that camp right from the get-go. Kaka is up in the area. It could go for that dual lane. It's something that we saw a lot out of, I want to say, was it Wolf? It might have been Wolf from WESG. Regardless, it's a really strong lane. It's hard to deal with. SD Invoker, we've seen what this guy can do. He's done it time again. Always causes issues, causes for concern. They have some of the heroes in the game that can probably help to deal with it. But to me, this is feeling like it might be a farm fiesta.
The battle begins.
I will say that in those types of games, newbie have felt like they always come on top, and I think that they have a lineup that allows them to get it again. Because there's a good chance that what you just get here is, like, if you didn't necessarily bring Kaka into the fold, if KP has U9 inside of them, they kill off anybody. Oh, this is luck. That's a little unfortunate, but it wouldn't have mattered. XE was there to break it anyways. And it is going to be a Kunkka Sand King dual offlane. I really like this. I think that this has potential to be incredibly strong. You're gonna do a lot of pinch. Witch Doctor could potentially die, even at level 3 if he's not careful. So this is gonna be a kill lane. Also, XZ and Ahmet can go for it as well, and there's the setup. They quite hit it perfectly, and Kaka, that was gonna get just down, did not get that off in time. And because of that implication, the lane becomes more difficult. It uses the spin, so it's gonna be on cooldown for a little while at least. Mid lane, Invoker versus Tinker. I probably don't even need to keep my eyes up as well. U9 is going to get free farm. This is where the action's going to be taking place. If somebody dies mid, it is a tremendous outplay. Likewise, we've also got the Darkseer that's off in the jungle. He's going to be Iron Talon. I imagine comes in this lane eventually. He might not, actually. They could just leave Faith a zone devices. It's not as scary him getting a lot of farm as it would be other hero. A little bit of a misplay there as well. They don't quite get the pull through, and because of that, they might have to try and tower slightly. Couldn't be the worst thing in the world, but everybody back under control. So mid, we're now seeing a rotation from Kaka to try and help. So maybe it's just to come and contest this rune. They want to make sure that they don't put that one over for stack in the camps. Elder's moving in to try and secure themselves the rune, and
regeneration.
Easy peasy. Looking for a Torn. Connects. Get it in time to get the bonus of regen. So again, a little bit of a weird one, but found in. He takes some damage.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
And this is going to be a problem, possibly. They're trying to clarity up, and I imagine that he's just trying to soak up experience, but there's still going to be all those denies. Yeah, still stuck at level 1. Oh. And again, the Torrent. I don't know. I think if you're going for that type of lane, you have to go and make the plays yourself as far as setting up for the kill first. And this isn't going very well for newbie at the start. Problem is, there's not a good other answer either. They could bring in the Shadowman and try and fully contest, but like newbie content to just keep playing with this. And it's getting you a lot of experience. Comparing 9's farm right now to the Juggernaut, it's pretty equal, but they're like one wave contested, eh? while the Sand King is making his rotation in towards mid, so they're switching it out and trying to get one of these heroes a couple of levels while the other one is at least able to apply some harassment onto the mid lane, because if Kirk is being hurt now, this is the other problem. Currently, you're set at 6 on the tank versus the 9 and 7 on the so it does not feel like they're getting what they need. And this is probably going to be read as well by LED. They'll realize that this rotation could happen. Do they have vision up? Have this ward up on the top side. And that might spot out. Oh, it does bottom up. It does bear fruit. We can maybe find a kill here. Nobody back in the top lane, though. Maybe he should realize that this is coming. And he's going to walk away. They get the cooldown. It is going to be enough for a set. Is it gonna damage? The friction machine turns around on Etsy and they do find a kill, but Shadow Demon takes down the Tinker first. So a little bit of into the favor of Ubi. I'm not sure if it's enough to make up for the early problems he's thinking, though. That's the issue. Invoker is still gonna be struggling in the play. He's gonna come back in a second. I think it's okay. It's very back and forth, but LGD are getting the better end of the laning stage already. Ame is getting farmed about equal with Lifestealer, but you've got the Darkseer that's just getting so much more out of this. Ostensibly, what they've rated is Newbie are getting a farmed Shadow Demon as opposed to a farmed Sand King. And while Faith is going to be able to make some plays happen, if this is going to pay off for Newbie, he has to find initiation after initiation consistently. And this ward right here is not going to be able to allow that to happen. They need to make more smoke ganks and rotations, like, which is not easy to find. So, this early lane stage, I would say LGD are coming out ahead. There's no doubt about it. They can make the rotations with attack. A9 in fast bomb. It's going to be very strong. But, yeah, they need to switch the. They're putting face up in the top because they realize he's the only one that can place them. Ame is going to have Omni Slash soon, and he needs to be able to position himself to stay alive. And now, he's snowballing as well. He's got to mark the machines on. A Sand King who is going to have to transition back into a Sandstorm Jungle role. So they're making the best of it they possibly can. But maybe this is actually okay. This could have been bad design for Ruby. If Faze is the one tower for all of a sudden you put yourself in a position where he can also farm into this hard camp here. And if he starts going into a ring neck, that looks a little bit better. Oh man, but yeah, all of that shell creeps. Darkseer will become a problem. 6 minutes in. You're pulling it back a little bit with the slight lead. We'll have to see where the rotation comes. Problem is that everything from Newbie is very predictable as far as what they could. And in the meantime, this is just a lot of speed to get in. So he's getting everything that he wants for this laning stage. I think LGD are all the great stuff. Did prioritize shutting down maybe here because he's not going to stop farm and he's going to get like 10 minute bots.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
The way it's been. Not mention that you Ame pushing in the tier 1 tower here. Can spin and press out. They're making move. This is not spot anymore. That ward did expire. You know, they won't try and contest stats. They've already been at least somewhat hampered in.
Dire's
taking these now, the early rotation from you is good, but
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
These, didn't even wait until it comes back. Now they're gonna dance from him. It's pinged out. Tinker realizes that this is happening. I think they might see the dance with sword. They've got eyes on everyone trying to take this away, able to dodge away from it at the moment. And meanwhile, the cask gonna start to bound. They're throwing up the shadow poison, collecting onto a couple of them. They try to stop this. 5 heroes in the mid lane. And now you've got the chase. Can have the Omni Slash bomb and be able to find it. Fate ends up being brought down. Now, Leather said you can find a turn and make something of this, but they're not going to be able to find anything. So again, they did this down and steal the stacks. Some of it had already been taken by the tinker as they were able to clear off this medium one. And they didn't contest this stack either. So I still think if you're LG, pretty happy with this. LGD have playing this game just as perfectly
Dire's
as you can
middle
afford.
Tower
I've been very
attack.
Impressed with them. And now moving in, Kaka's going to get down. There's no way to stop this. This should be a pretty quick and easy hit for him. Trying to find it, and he ends up going down to the creeps, but still, that rotation in. A little bit of a haste turn for maybe. Starting this game in exception fashion. Very impressed. U9 still struggling to find something. They need to get KP farmed. He has to get that blink dagger online. And it just doesn't feel like it's going to happen. Starting out that maybe here, this ward does not block a camp, so it allows just to have free in as far as vision in this area. Really like this stuff from LGD and the way they've been playing it. Not expecting to come in as a prison press by how they're this playing. The thing that's most impressive to me about this LGD is this is a new lineup that's been making these types of plays, and I guess they have a bit of a target back because they've been the best team in China up until this point. But it's also, I mean, this is a newbie team that beat Secret in a best of three. They did end up losing in the best of five. But they put up a really good show. Like, this is an LGD team that, if you compare the results across the different games and across the different teams, they're very strong.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
It's a far cry from what we saw at TI, that's for sure. If he could go for the first strike, he wants to, but Ame's gonna back out and not gonna do it.
Well-gotten gains.
I mean, the fact that that maybe is just getting free reign here. Like, the stacks got taken, so it does slow down his bots a little bit. We talked about a 10-minute timing, almost there. KP gonna burrow straight to the high ground. Kaka shuts as well, and now XS is getting caught by the boat. He was nicely played there by Kaka, started to bring him lower. The is gonna be on point. Invoker finds the kill on the other side. Ame is gonna get controlled for the win. He's gonna try and TP out, and he will be able to escape. So, TP spin. Good stuff still. They find at least one kill. And just very technically, Shadota coming out from LG. Very impressive stuff. U9 is going to have to back out now as Ame to TP down bottom. Does have Omni Slash still available. Did not kill off the Lifestar because of that.
Attack.
Does beat back home to the fountain. SC in the meantime, Hand of Midas, all completed. Actually, his continue just gets brought out to him.
Dire's top tower.
Is forcing him back. This game is going to go Dire's late.
Radiant's bottom tower.
I mean,
newbies
still
have
the timing that they can. That's going to strong.
Radiant's bottom tower.
LGD are looking to be ahead. Have a real strat. Very nicely played.
Is under attack.
Wow, they brought another one of those imprisons onto the dark seat. Four heroes in the area for newbie. For initiation, Kaka has max text. Does also have the torrent. Outs it, uses it for vision. Hit blind on Darkseer, because why not? Well played there.
Radiant's bottom
the whole
tower
time,
is
you
under
still
attack.
Have this juggernaut that's in the bottom lane. Nobody is responding to this. Nuke are going to cut, but at least take substantial tower damage. A great.
Radiant's GP bottom tower is under
KP
attack.
Not wanting to call kill. They're going to keep in on top of the creeps, because guess what? Tinker has bots. But nonetheless, they don't score. Juggernaut is still farming away like the madman. Ame is getting everything that he wants out of this. The early Vanguard build, Spider-Man, is transitioned to basically whatever he wants afterwards. Does need to be a little bit careful, but nonetheless. On to XC. Can't get the kill. With the vacuum back, almost getting disrupted there. It's very close. They have another surge looking for need time and isn't going to be able to get out of there. And it's what we talked about earlier for this lineup. Like, I think this newbie draft is very strong, but the weak spot has consistently been. Stan King is not getting the farm that he needs. He has to stay alive in this team fight, so it relies on Kaka to find that initiation, because why he's maxing X.
Dyer's
when
middle tower
just
is
dodge
under attack.
And you don't find the initiations onto that Tinker, who's been oh so elusive, becomes really rough. Bottom lane. Kame now with his Vanguard Yasha completed. Like, the fact that they've gotten so much out of this early game is just terrifying. Tinker is.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
He can go whatever he wants now. It really doesn't hurt. It's very impressive play. Meanwhile, the rotation in. Eski is trying to defend against this. He's not nearly strong enough to stop. He's been hitting the Tillum as well, and Invoker is great against Tinker if you can find one of those potatoes. Like, it's always that crapshoot about who has the better vision, but the better ability to find the heroes, and that's what Elder Titan is going to help LG with, but I'm not sure how exactly you stop this now. Ame, caught up this
tower is under attack.
They've got Alien Ward, the Witch Doctor heals.
Radiant's middle tower
and this lineup from LG, it tells you exactly what they want to try and accomplish. All
Radiant's
of these heals.
Middle tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is under attack.
Peace. Dire's no blink dagger online. I don't know how you stop this.
Double damage.
Oh. 15 minutes in, it's developed into a 3,000 net worth lead. Newbie's catching back up in terms of experience. And this is the play that KD has tried to make, and he can't successfully off him. LGD at the home log. This is what I was talking about. This is what I can do. Is hide in the trees, try to go for a counter initiative with a faceless blade. When he was
Radiant's
doing it, he would go blink. Bonus Paco would find with the ship.
Your
Sand King
is
not
attack.
Really going to be effective. Paco trying to find maybe. Blinks away in trouble. Alright, but now he found the Elder Titan. He's gone. Ame's here. They're trying to TP out. Do not want to get caught. Kaka's gone, but they keep a lot of the unit and lifestealer. Kaka's just trying to create a base now, but he's going to go down. And just like that, they find a kill on the ET, lose the Tunka. If they can slow down this push, that's the way it goes. X level 7 of a cask. Got maybe blink dagger done. Still not full damage. What's up next? I'm still waiting to see what he opts to go for. There's a lot of different routes to go for. Not an armlet, that's so almost fun. Keeping with it. Just gonna have to wait for a team fight to come out. And maybe going back to the Aether Lens build. So, Aether Lens, Agnes eventually. Ame's going for a battle period. Time to farm. There is potentially not gonna be already there's not very much fighting. I think we're gonna continue that trend. Kaka looks for a pickoff. SC is here as well. They get a torrent. It's just the forge here. It's for now. There's the torrent. That ship comes out as well. Good reaction from Ame. Is not going to get caught out by that. And now Kaka, a little bit too far foot, is going to get slept by the T. Maybe shows up, jumps forward, laser hit as well. Kaka is very, very tanky, but he puts it down in the end. So 17 minutes in, they find another kill on the Tunka. They're ready to start pushing powers. LGD. There. dotting their I's and crossing their T's.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
I really like this newbie lineup, but I think that LGD have had the answer.
Radiant's
this
bottom
is what
tower
they've been running consistently, and it's just looked so good for a while. They still have a lot of other options for things that they might eventually go for. Now Electric Steeler takes down the tower.
Radiant structures are fortified.
Bottom Norris is there.
Dire's top tower is under Smart attack.
Spot. Bait.
Radiant's bottom tower is under
for
attack.
A hit now. Pops the torrent onto Ame as well.
Radiant's
back
bottom
out, though,
tower has fallen.
I don't end up finding the anything. So LC tower. Escalators online. I will say this is sort of reminiscent of what Yubi was doing pre-TI. What you have is they would basically, if you imagine, for me it always felt like they were playing like a spring, like a slinky or something, you know? They would get scrunched up really, really tight. They would be pushed back up against their base. Their tier threes would eventually get pressured, and then one overstep, one wrong play, and they would suddenly punish the enemy team and win the game from there. This lineup does have potential to come back into this game. It just needs to be through team fighting and finding pickoffs, which they can do. And EP now with the Blink Dagger has the tools with which to do it and might be able to make it happen if he can find good initiation. I think he just needs to get out of there. Jumps forward, moves on to the Dark Seeker. This would be a two boulders. The rest of the idea is here. Never mind. He's just going to destroy the Witch Doctor. KP is still in some trouble, though. Earth Splitter connects onto KP. This doesn't play it, but now they're chasing down U9. Okay. They get out of here. Instead, he's going to turn now onto the Earth Spear. Gets a little bit lucky with a couple of those Omni Slash bounces, but he still ends up going down. So 2-for-2 exchange, but they lost their Lifestealer and Jug. 2-to-160 blast hits. Battle Fury, Vanguard, and Yasha. Just a monster. But out to be lined up in that Shadow is getting bombed. And he is, Shadow Demon is a really great hero. I think an underrated hero against Juggernaut. As we see, like, maybe Tinker continue to just.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
That's with Provoker. Your ulti goes through the BKB, so Spin is not going to be able to chase people down. You have the potential to kite. Also, Juggernaut Illusions. They struggle if you actually end up sticking those onto some of the supports of LGD. Illusions hit really hard. U9, this is a little bit interesting. They run into each other in the woods. And now U9 starting to chase. He is going to do some damage. If U9 had Rage right there, I don't think he finds it because of that Vanguard, but it would have done something. SC, Yule Scepter now building into the X. And being this 2-point box is going to start to be able to put more into Wex. Once you get those a little bit higher, the team fight potential becomes very potent. Oh, the low ground, they caught up. Spot everybody. Can they get it? Works pretty well as far as being able to get control onto the Juggernaut. They're going to keep pulling everybody. See, drop the wall. Damage Kaka's just gonna run away. Ame trying to just block the energy. U9 is all gonna get down. They have their ult and it comes in well. They are looking so prominent in this game. This has been really, really well done. I'm gonna figure for newbie what happens for some type of smoking or pick off KP. Oh my god, does T have any idea? He's gonna spot that these trees are gone. They're there. He's in the area. Isn't gonna go though. At least for now. If he spots that these trees are on, all right. Not gonna do it. The thing that's nuts about this to me is that this same draft that Newbie has taken, pretty much, they've beaten every other team in China with it. Like, I don't know if maybe this means that they're going to need to adjust or something, but it's looked really dominant for them consistently. Maybe it's just that Newbie haven't found the pickoffs yet. That's something that if they do find those early, LGD might start to look a little bit more hampered and under the gun. But as it stands right now, it's a 7,500 net worth lead, right around 4,000 experience.
Double damage.
Pikaka, this is the type of play. It's like actually I was saying, you gotta go for smoke play. You gotta make something happen with your lineup. And finding an Elder Titan, this is one way to do it. It's the start. It made it work.
No match for my master.
Meanwhile, Guardian Greaves is the pick for the Darkseer. Tier 2 tower bottom had already been taken by LGD. And I'm waiting to see when they go for the next round. This Juggernaut is just gonna be so hard to deal with all game for Newbie. Lifestealer needs to get huge. Yeah, I ended up going back with Sanj. I wonder if he goes for a Halberd.
Radiant's
it might not be the worst thing in the
attack.
World.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Well, 4,800 gold on the Tinker. This is just a tried and true LGD game, and maybe is looking to at least have the possibility to carry this team. Whether it can actually happen or not, it's going to come down to the team fights and how they play out. But they're certainly looking good so far. And likewise, I would say that be not falling crazy far behind, taking team fights that are bad for themselves, this is the way they have to play this game. I said earlier it was going to be a farm fiesta. We've only got 17 kills in 25 minutes. Certainly the case. Did they find me? Doesn't look like it yet. He's in the area. He was looking for him, but guess he didn't find him. And this is just the inherent problem with Vivi's draft, is that if they don't find those payoffs, things become very hard. They do find them, it's all great. It's all fine dandy. Movement in towards the Roche Pit. Ame, Phase, Blink, Battle Fury, Manta, Vanguard. Hanging out, they realize what's going on. Shadow Demon Faith, they think something's happening here, and this might be a time when the KP Blink Dagger reveal with the Epicenter can come into play. They're not taking it too quickly as he throws in the knife. And Imp is also going to get dropped on the backline to be able to initiate. XD is gone. Unite is going to keep chasing after them here. Maybe going to be able to find a kill. The Sheepstick comes out. The reveal from Maybe is going to go on to Unite. He drops. Just like that, buying the Sheepstick and catching them off guard. Kaka's gone down too. Oh, maybe it's going to start making them pay. This is a problem. How do you stop this guy? Faith is now also going to get out. Maybe can they turn it back around? Though he's out of mana. SC is on a killing spree. KP is on top of this Tinker. And if he can find a kill, back into the Earth Splitter. Good stuff from the rest of the side of LGD, and now maybe he's regen enough that he's going after SC himself, wants to find the kill, ghost walk away, and no reveal. Man, they have to go for the Echo Stomp lest those Forge Spirit find the kill, and now SC jumps forward, it's going to instead turn around and beat him down. Cool guys don't look at their right clicks landing. So the end result is 1,000 gold lead. That cheap stick reveal. Very nicely clicked by the beast. Interesting. Well, Roshan's not working out for LGD, but that cheap stick from maybe. I was wondering if they were gonna go for the type of gold. The classic is going for Agonist, but against this lineup, when so much of the damage of Nuvia is dependent on just those two cores. I mean, in these team fights, Kaka's more about survivability than he is about the damage. But Invoker also, if he wants to, he could go back for the sheet deck, and then it all just comes down to vision game.
Wicked sick.
Oh god. Alright, what the hell is he scores in an ounce? It King Fine ends up going down to maybe. Do we find this? Maybe. They wanted him. That was bad.
Top tower.
They don't get
attack.
The guy. And now you don't have Sand King. Now Roshan's going down. Oh buddy. We said that he would have the potential to carry them, and so far as he goes back in, they gotta put down some of those tier wards. I'm not sure if it's gonna be good enough, but he's keeping them on this side of the map. Newbie do not realize or cannot do anything about the fact that Roshan has been taken.
Roshan has fallen to the dying. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah. I think that maybe it is proving that he doesn't have to go down right here. Maybe it's the best thing if I long shot. Everything that I've seen from... But GD, this spot is looking very good. Ame, farming
Radiant's
up the storm. He can build into Abyssal soon. Their movements around the map, the way that they responded to ganks, all look good. And I'm first to admit, Newbie, they've been favored the team for a while, but now they're just being dismantled. Another deal in their favor, and that's going to be enough for them to take this tier 2 tower.
Radiant's middle tower has fallen.
Keep your eyes on this team. Because it might continue. Alright, what do we got next? Late mail is going to be the pickup for the Darkseer after casual. So, that's spell resistance, extra survivability. Now, I'm assuming it's going to go back to the Shiva's guard. Link forward from Ame, cutting the creep wave. Over here to the side, KP, they have good vision in the area. They have Kaka as well as U9 Lifestealer. If they can get the counterpoint, KP seems to go onto the Darkseer. He's going to go down. Flash comes out as well. We're too tanky to be brought in just the Omni though. And now U9 chasing. He has the right clicks there. They have the ET as well as the air, so he's gonna be catching him here though. And he slows down. Three dead. Newbie fight back. ...3,200 gold swing. This game is gonna end up being really good. Ladies and gentlemen. I am excited to see this because to me, I mean, it's still an upper bracket matchup. It's not an elimination one, but this is going to be good. All right, Ame building now into a Battle Fury. I want to see what this guy's GPM is going to be at. I mean, SC is still going pretty high up there.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
WD continue winning like this. Ame is going to start getting into those silly numbers for Juggernaut. Ekmark's the spot combo, pulling Kaka back. This is their classic play that Newbie have been doing for a while, is they'll stick the KP over somewhere where they can find a solo kill, bring Kaka with them, and then afterwards go for the initiations. They're bringing U9 with them as well this time around. He's waiting for his... Asher, but the problem is all of LGD is grouping together. So this is not going to work out for them, and maybe find Hakka. They try and KP as well. This could be. Oh man! All right, they're looking and they're finding vacuum onto him. He's going down too, just like that. LGD grouping up as five. They take down the Sand King and the Kunkka, and it feels like they have the answer.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
I mean, Tinker 9-1-8.
Radiant structures are fortified.
He's been a part of almost all of his team. He's been a part of every team kill, pretty much, except for the two that were happening early on.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
All of them since the laning stage, and now Ame hitting the tier 3 towers. What are you going to do to stop him? He has his agent there. They don't even
Radiant's
care.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
He was traditionally known as the base breaker for a long time in China because of what he does in these situations. Not to mention giving the vision to bucket spam from Tinker.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
This high ground scene is disgusting. They get a tornado. Alright. They don't have the skirt with them right now.
Radiant's
he needs to come back into the fray. Ame in the barracks. They will create some of the teams up, but the torrent goes out as well. So hitting the back, he ups the high, but as he is jumping, they're going to get the wraparound. Oh, the bullet, cold snap, and that Omni is still going to be controlled, and maybe also going down. They run off the ledge, but the emphasis is still going to be the turnaround is huge. Four drops down, five, and this should end up being another flood. Ame slowed for the moment now, also having Christian, and no way he gets out of this one. Don't believe? Well, he's pretty swift. FC looking for the play. The tornado's a little bit off, and he does escape. Ame, well, maybe FC's still chasing. They want to find him, and there's the ghost walk forward, getting slowed down, and he lifts up his ice wall as well. Does he have enough to get out of there? Goes for the spin. The longest chase in the world. Ame, they can get the Alacrity on him. Cold snap, that should be enough. Definitely blast the arms. They find the kill. We're done. Wicked six streak. So the turnaround is real. And this is what I was talking about much earlier. That when you look at we have played, like, they're like this kinetic energy being balled up, a spring being pushed in. And then eventually something flips and LGD make a little move. All of that explodes out, and they find a couple of kills. So really good move right there by Newbie, punishing the overextension, LGD, the wraparound, the sinking in the Invoker does bear fruit. And this is going to pull them back into the game. Still keeping it into that lead for LGD, but not so steer that Newbie can't come back. Oh, they happen to walk by. Unfortunate for him there. Jam on the ground. That is a huge pickup. Now looking for more. They get the Yule Scepter lift up onto the Elder Titan. Suddenly cracks in the armor. LGD, they lift it onto one. Now with a Burrow Strike. Meatball combo with the Definitive Blast. Four stepped away. Guardian just keeps him alive. Nicely played there.
Dire's
the
middle
plays, the counterplay. They're real. It's happening. And Newbie poised to try and tail some structural damage of their own.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Dire's structures are fortified.
Alacrity on Lifestealer. What a combination.
Dire's bottom tower has fallen.
Yet again, Midibi is going to push in this top lane here. As he is in the area, wants to find him. Tornadoes to the right. Maybe he was left.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
But I mean, how much cooler can he get? If it comes down to the wire, two of the best. Here, oh, Epicenter looking for it. He's gonna get the Sunstrike as well. That's the killed godlike streak for SC. I casted a series a while ago with Merlini where he said that maybe was the best invoker in China. And SC right now is eating that title. KB is picked up for the Juggernaut. It's nice. You gotta go for that.
To the Swift. The Spores.
Look at it go.
Liking this so far. The big problem is that it is still kind of like Lifestealer and Invoker against the world, and maybe has a sheep. And that poses a big problem. So in that instance, you think about that fight that happened along the top lane. What ended up happening was they knew where the siege was coming from. They knew where LGD was, and Nubi was able to take advantage of that. The vision game becomes paramount now, and making sure that you're warding it good, making sure that you have eyes on your opponents, that's the most important thing from this point on. Like, as long as they're on full farm leech, it feels like they're probably going to be. Oh, and the smoke gank. Oh, if they can find it right away, then the jump forward. Sheep as well. Good little sword going down. The quick cut bouncing the other way. Able to get off the death gate blast. Wallen's going to get caught again, though. Instant trouble. Counter initiation isn't there. Isn't enough because they have eyes on that. They take him down in the end. Ame, Tantillion, go back in again. They bought back to the invoker, but they kill off the creeps. He need to. And now, can they kill off? This is the combo again. The X is going to be there, and now pull him back in. Bringing him low, they do find that goal. 9, the double. Looking for the Darkseer now, trying to find him and just in the direction. He tries to get out, but isn't going to happen. Meanwhile, Punka X himself, Lotus Orbs abound. Man, these team fights are going to start to become insane. The reaction there from Kock immediately disabling the Hex. Really good stuff. Did cost them an Invoker buyback, but it will be worth if they secure Roshan. Well done.
Roshan has fallen to the Radiant.
Gold for my chest.
Now, X now has his Heat of Midas done. And this is the combination that they're just going to keep going back to for Nubi. Sand King looking for a Burrow Strike Epicenter. I'm so excited that they gave him the hero they put in. I'm really pleased that we're going to see Nubi Tinker versus an SC Invoker. It's like they're daring each other. Who's going to back down? Who's going to be the one that bans it out? This is going to be one of those games. Esty goes back for the Sheepstick himself. Man, positioning. Throwing stuff. It's no longer like huge tornado combos. It's just about finding baby. And likewise for LGD, it's about finding SC. You look at all of these other itemizations that they've got. Blink Dagger on Shadyman, as well as the Glimmer Gate. Kako went back for the Lotus Orb. You got drums there. They're all built around Lotus Orb on Sand King. It's built around keeping SC alive. Lifestealer is going to be going for the FKB now. His job is to kill off that jug. Both teams in this game have the tools with which to outplay their opponents, and it's just going to come down to skill in these team fights. And it's gonna
Dire's
be epic.
Bottom tower
can't wait.
Has fallen.
Right. Siege is getting ready to start up.
Dire's
we're about as even in terms of
attack.
Net worth as we can get. Experience into the fit for Nubi though by a large margin. And U9. Oh, this is the this is what we gotta do. Kaka Xing U9, waiting for rage to be done and going in. They steal some damage to the tower and then they force the back out. Little damage here and there. And as far as these matches can go at this point in time, it's about as even as it could get.
Radiant's top players are under attack.
I saw the back. Back, defend their tower, defend their barracks. Get ready to do it all again. It's like watching a chess match, honestly. Both teams very much in tune with each other, where they need to play around the map, what needs to happen. another look at the GM continuing to skyrocket and see there herself. And with the Aegis in hand, probably feels pretty comfortable taking a fight now. Octoring Court completed. And is going to take that instead of the blip. Oh, it's a scary one. That is one problem that you have as Invoker going up against the Tinker late game is positioning that you can get with the Tinker's Blink Dagger is really scary. They're wrapping around. They have the Darkseer here as well. This Ruler Flip Machine actually it's not gonna get caught out. New steady again to try and go along this bottom lane. U9 and SC. All of the damage on their back, pretty much. Kaka at this point is just rum buff on command. Here goes the rage move forward. It's alright. He forces out the Blade Fury and they back out. Stomp connected on the three, but they're still alive. Oh man, Darkseer won that one. They actually went for the Earth Splitter as well. So now no Earth Splitter. Another avenue for Newbie to go for this. And it's all fun. 41 HP left on it. They throw out a tornado, keeping the rest of the side of LTD at bay. The big problem they have is that top lane is continuing to push in. If Nubian forced to back out, LGD can push very hard. Another combination for Macready. Ave's pretty upset about the situation. They're taking damage. They do pull him back. That coconut is going to bounce around a little bit. But yeah, they retreat. And the ice wall for the retreat as well. Maybe was almost positioned up in a sheep stick, but I mean, look at this. It's almost mirrored against each other across each of the lanes. Got this top lane that's put in with just the range racks. Now bottom lane's going to be pushing in with the melee barracks. And neither team is really willing to give up at all. Eventually, I think this does need to come down to LGD finding them out and like making a play across the map. They need find a pickoff, because if we are allowed to do that ad nauseum, they're just going to win the game by virtue of slowly tearing down their tier threes. And you can see that they're set up right now. LGD are the trees looking for a counterplay. It is potentially available, but Lotus Orb is going to make any abyssal play coming out from the Juggernaut not really viable. Bottom lane, maybe it's cold from the bank. And still, the scans, I'll be able to scout them out. Oh, you said it earlier, Barn was gonna be the name of the game, and they certainly did not disappoint on that front. Scotty picked up for the jug. Bottom lane, LG are trying to set up on this, but S should be able to keep them out there for a while.
Dire's top tower is under attack. Dire's top tower is falling.
This is very much, like, you look and they're actually all set up here. Maybe it's to keep them off the tower and tornado. Could have been rough. All right, ready to go. LGD
Dire's
smoke is there.
Is under attack.
Nuke have the vision Dire's advantage here if they don't get caught out by the initial smoke play. Amanato spots it, blinks away to bait. They catch him there. She's in connection. Not quite enough damage on the other side, and it looked like Tinker was able to already escape. They lose the life, they were in an inch for the right now. The invoke to kill off the witch. Back by this now.
But now maybe he's found SC. He's in a lot of trouble. They're going to be able to get him. He's going to have SC. He's going to go down. Where is it? They're not there. Cocked a Lotus Orb on cooldown for another 3 seconds. He's still going to be able to turn this one back around. Apple Ame is going to get sheeped up instead. And the counter initiation play is there with Tornado. After the Witch Doctor buyback, they're looking for KP again. Maybe deep in them, but they're not going to be able to find him. So the end result is a buyback on the Witch Doctor. SC was able to kill him off. KT went dead also. But again, just these team fights are on a razor's edge.
I'll take that as tribute.
Newbie now, looking again to come and contest Roshan. This might be the moment. Pop down the ball. Deafening Blast pushing that T up to the high ground. He's coming. But with the X marks the spot, pullback. SC's gonna be fine. Throw the Lotus Orb onto KP. Meanwhile, the Lotus Orb is there. Pops BKB. The runaround is able to find Amit. KP somehow splitting through all that. Is BKB, and now Kaka is gonna die. Both goes out. Alacrity onto you, turns onto Ame. They're able to make it to the ice hole. Now they found maybe good force that way. ET keeping him alive. A second force that they don't have the damage to kill him. Maybe Deafening Blast comes out, but he's already gone. We're looking for the blood on the other side of the fucking who's battling against the Darkseer? He goes down. And now found Ame. He does have another injury. Can they get out of there? Kaka smells blood, the pickup buys back. Ghost walk forward, found maybe. Oh, he breaks the blade. Now they found him, sheeps it there as well, and trying to bring him down. U9 rage up and brought down. Nice blade. Ame getting right click and cold snap. They don't have the tornado to be able to bring him down, and maybe buys back. Goes after U9 now. The team fight that never ends. Rage up. If they can bring him down, it's going to be huge. Maybe he's dead. He did not have buyback at this point. They might have potentially done it just off of that one pick. Turning onto the buildings, they've got the creep wave here as well. 100 seconds, no maybe. And it looks like the tier 3 tower is going down. This could potentially be it.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
And the plays in this game have been absurd.
Dire's middle barracks.
Ame gets sheeped down. I think that
Dire's
they've done it.
Invisibility.
LG boots. Not barracks. 82 seconds. Still a tinker. This have to be tremendous. They had Dark for that. All the he's already going down. Deafening Blast. All right, they keep him alive. We played there. His team said to keep him a little bit more survivable. U9, X, and Rage. A hard life out here. Get the healing ward is still now pulled back. Witch Doctor hold it from the high ground. The vacuum wall. Time's dropping, and the Omni Slash is getting bounces back and forth. Ame getting hexed up from the SC blitz to the side. They do finally bring down that score. Still 40 seconds. No Tinker. The hold is going to have to be tremendous. Like I said, they do find the kill on Ame now. E-box back. XZ getting chased down by the Shadow Demon and KP. He's still trying to control this SC. He's never going to stop. Another Lotus Orb taking off the Sheepstick. Looking for the counterplay. KP just trying desperately to get out of there. Popped up with the dual scepter. He doesn't have any way out at this point, though. He is finally going to be brought down. But the tower, the barracks, they're all going down for LGD. Still 13, 12 seconds with no Tinker. They need to escape. U9 lifted up with the dual scepter. They desperately want to control him. They do finally find it with the rest. And can they bring him down? Go for the turnaround play. SC is here, realizes that maybe is showing up. They jump inside of SC! Oh, SC saves the day! They're gonna be able to escape! Oh my god, U9 Lifestealer jumps inside, but maybe would have killed off SC, and now they're gonna play again! Go back in the game, he might go down!
Dire's
can't find this kill! Oh, U9, he might have been off more than he can. SC is gonna be controlled as well! That was not to go back in it now! SC, she ticked to death. He's going down. And did they counter throw? Invoker has buyback. They're going to be okay. And the whole time through, Tier 4s, they're going down. they have one Rage Barracks left. The pickoff on maybe in the Roche pit. It was too much. And still the kills even. Oh, what a game. I mean, it's still only 7,500 net worth lead, but the big thing is the structural damage. And the fact that Nubi was fighting on the LG side of the map. Game number one. Oh, lordy. Witch Doctor. A little bit underfarmed. And I think that right now, Nubi are feeling comfortable. You gotta be feeling good at this point. Got another shot at it. 53 minutes in. Time for me to take a drink of water. God. Everybody has been playing out of their mind this game. Honestly, this feels like it could be a grand final just in terms of like how much these teams are taking this. This is round one of a qualified tournament. And these types of plays are coming out. Like, what? How is this to Summit 6 is gonna be dope. Alright, Ame.
Radiant's middle tower.
Starting to bring down. They catch a torrent. Also gonna put his opening for his pick. Meanwhile, KP went for the FD. No, he didn't go for the stomp on him. But now they've been able to find him. Lotus Orb, Yuka's gonna lift him back up. Wants to burrow strike away, and it's gonna be able to escape. LG inside of Goofy Pinches.
Radiant's middle tower.
They're set up again with the ET. Have stomp available. Yummy. Imprisonment from the Shadow Demon. Looking for another counterplay here from the ET. And the stomp, it connects on Essie and Kaka. Alright, that might be a little bit of a problem. World Strike is still on the two control. They turn around the tornado. They're still looking for a kill. Everybody from LHD is still alive. Nubi kind of blew their load a little bit onto him. It doesn't look like they want to try and invest anymore right now. LHD waiting for the next round. Their base is still being pushed in. Maybe he's not there with them. And he's the only one with the Aegis. Alright. Another imprisonment coming. Let's take a look. Is there any new items of real consequence yet? Oh, Ame. Need some more damage now.
The instructions are fortified.
They are getting hit. Also caught down. And now, losing the darks here, LTG, what is going on? They're striking back now, and maybe it's not with the rest of his team. Where are you at right now, buddy? SC double kill, they take down another. U9 gets a double kill. They're already buying back on several heroes, but newbies smelling blood. They're going for the base. Oh, baby. SC finds anybody gone. His invoker play has been immaculate, and now turning on to the barrack. Has the alacrity on, forces out the glyph. Maybe, with his VKB available, could go for an initiation play. Lifts him up with these suckers. Get about going back in. He's gonna put out the VKB, but he maybe he's gone. Oh, that potentially could be it. I don't know if LPD can hold him more. Ice Ball is down, they found him. They catch the darts here before he throws anything. Maybe Tinker as well. I hope they enjoyed the broadcast. @LyricalDota. You can follow me on Twitter if you feel so